Hello everyone and welcome back to the introduction to the UE4 Editor series. In this video we're going to talk about rotating objects. So we have our basic project that we've been working out of here. I've just created a new level and dragged in our SM chair here so that we have something to rotate. When we select it by default, as we mentioned in our previous video, we have access to the move tool so that we can move our object, but we're going to rotate it. So you can go ahead and press the E key. That will allow you to switch to the rotation tool. You can also get to this by clicking the icon in the upper right-hand corner of the viewport, this center icon. So we have move and we have rotate. And in the next video, we'll talk about scale. When you get to the rotation tool, you can see it has three color-coded arcs here. This represents your Z, X, and Y axis. So Z is blue. If we click on it, you can see a compass will come up. This allows you to see just how much you are rotating your object along the Z, for instance, in this example. We are currently rotating in 10-degree increments. In a moment, we'll talk about how you can change that as well. But just want to illustrate that you can also rotate along the Y, and you can rotate along the X as well. So let's go and change the amount of degrees that we rotate our object, similar to the Move tool. In the upper right-hand corner, we can click the rotation grid snap value, click this little drop-down, and we can rotate in 5, 10, 15, 30, and so on. If we go ahead and select 5, for example, and rotate along the Z again, you can see we're moving a little bit smoother now. You can also click this icon here to enable or disable the snapping for the rotation grid. So if I turn this off, you can see we're getting smooth rotation all the way around. And we still have our compass to see just how much we are rotating our object. So let me turn that back on. There's one other option. You can rotate your objects in divisions of 360. So let's go ahead and set this to 45, for example. And now as we rotate, we are rotating in 45-degree increments. So let me set that back to default before I forget. The other thing I want to talk about is similar to the Move tool, we can rotate in world space or local space. Currently, we are set to world space. So as we, let's say, rotate our object on its side here and rotate it along the Z, you can see we are rotating it in world space along the floor here. But what if we wanted to rotate this object in its own local Z? Well, we can do that by clicking the globe icon up here in the center. And you can see how the gizmo changes. And now if we rotate, you can see we're rotating in its own local Z. You can also get to that by pressing Control and the tilde key to toggle between the two. The other method you could use to rotate your object is via the Details panel. So right here on the right, you have Location, Rotation, and Scale. So for rotation, I can punch in any value. I'm just going to zero out the X. I'm going to zero out the Y. And just zero out the Z again. And now it's at its default location. Now, this other thing I wanted to mention, when working with certain features such as rotators and the blueprint system, rotation is not broken down into X, Y, and Z, but instead is broken down into yaw, pitch, and roll. And how that relates to our gizmo here, the yaw is the Z, so this is our yaw, and the pitch is the Y, which is this. And the roll is the X, which is this. And that's basically it for rotating object. This is a short video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you in the next video.